All right, so in this lab, we're going to go ahead and check out gas chromatography. And chromatography refers to a separation of mixtures by pushing them through some sort of medium in which they move at different rates. So basically you put a mixture, push it through some sort of medium, they'll move through different rates and thus separate one another, and then you collect them at the end. And so the gas here refers to the phase of our sample. And so let's go ahead and check this out. So what we'll have is inside a syringe, right, that's my picture of a syringe there. We'll have a mixture of components. So I'll make them orange and purple. Right, in this case, there are going to be liquids, and then we'll put this into the GC, into our insertion area right here. And then behind here is basically just this coiled column. And this coiled column inside of here is sometimes a liquid, sometimes a solid, but it's a stationary phase. And then we're pushing gas through the whole time. Some sort of inert gas that won't react with our own compounds. And this is our mobile phase. And so what happens when we insert this sample, it's gonna vaporize the compounds into gas. And then as they flow through these components, they'll start slowly separating from one another. And so that's why you want a long column, because you get more time to separate. And then at the end, one will come out at a time. And so then we can collect them. And we can also get a readout. So what you'll get is something like this, or over here is a response. And so this is there's a detector at the end that detects if something's coming out or not coming out. It doesn't tell you what, it just tells you that something's coming out. And then here we have time. At the beginning, you'll see it's relatively flat. Then we'll see a small peak, that'll be our air peak. And that's just the air that we put in the syringe going through the sample. And then we'll see a bigger peak. And then this will be kind of your first compound or your first component. And then after some other time, you'll see a second component. And so you can see that this will separate them out quite well. And so there's a lot of advantages to GC. It's really good at separating out similar compounds. Take a look at the compounds that we're using. Some of them are extremely similar, say almost the same boiling point, that kind of stuff. And yet our GC will still be able to separate them. It's relatively fast. This only takes like 10 minutes or so. It's quantitative. And so we can not just tell what we have in our mixture or how many things we have in our mixture, but how much of each one. And the way you figure that out is you take this area under this curve, and that'll directly relate to how much component is in there, right? So you can find out the ratio of how many components are in each one. And so for us, what we're gonna do is basically just take these peaks, cut them out, right? Print them off on a piece of paper, cut them out, and then weigh them. And then you can compare the ratios to see what your mixture is made out of. And then the fourth advantage is that it's non-destructive, depending on what kind of detector you have at the end. So you'll see ours is non-destructive. We're still gonna get some of our sample out, but we're still gonna lose some sample. But of course, there are disadvantages as well. And the main disadvantage is that since it's gas chromatography, your sample must be volatile, so it must be able to turn into a gas. And not only must they be able to turn it into a gas, they must be thermally stable, right? We got to heat them up to turn into a gas, and so they've got to be stable. So obviously not all compounds are these two things, so you can't use GC for everything, but it's still an extremely useful technique. This right here is a top-down picture of our GC, and it's opened up so we can see the insides of it. So here's our injection port down here. So that's where you're gonna take your sample. Then there's a little oven in here that heats up our gas. The gas then goes through this column and then out this side to the collection outlet where we can collect our gas. So let's go ahead and check out how this works. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and assemble our collection vial. We've got the conical vial right here, got this cap in the hole with it, an O-ring, the part that actually goes into the GC to receive the gas, and then a vial so we can put it in the centrifuge. So first off, just take a piece of cotton, put it in your plastic tube here and just jam it down there. And then we go ahead and take this piece right here with the ground glass joint, put it through the cap, and then you got to get this tiny O-ring on there, which is a bit of a pain. Cool. And then this part right here will go into the GC. We'll collect the gas in these two bubbles. We'll attach it here, put this in our vial, and then centrifuge all the gas back down here to our collection area. All right, so here we're gonna go ahead and pick up our sample. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your syringe, put it into the sample, and then pull out the proper amount of sample. In this case, we're gonna do 25 microliters. So we'll pull up until the 25 microliter mark. It's difficult to see, it won't really zoom in there, but it is approximately 25 microliters. And then you're just gonna pull the syringe up and pull the rest up to 100 microliters, with the rest just being an air peak. All right, so we've got our sample inside of our syringe. We've got our GC here. What we're gonna do is go ahead and hold the syringe correctly. So one hand hold right here, two fingers right on this port here, and then your thumb right here. What you're gonna do is you're gonna stab the GC, plunge the liquid in, and then smoothly pull out. You wanna keep your thumb here because it might push back and you don't want this syringe to fly back at you. And then after that, you're gonna push this little button that tells the GC to go ahead and record. So line it up, stab it in, squeeze it in, and then pull it out, and then press the button. And now you're recording. All right, so we're gonna collect our sample from this outlet. You can see right there, it says outlet on it. And so we're gonna take apart our collection vial here. Move the cap. Take this out, remove this conical vial down here, and then after the air peak comes, we're going to go ahead and attach it over here. So you're simply just going to take this, plug it into here, and then just screw it on lightly. Doesn't need to be too hard. And then the gas will come out and it'll condense in these two. We'll remove this. Attach it back to our vial and centrifuge to collect our sample. All right, so we're going to take our samples and centrifuge them. Let's go ahead and just insert them into centrifuge opposite sides so that way it's balanced. Close the centrifuge. And then centrifuge for about a minute. Right, turn off the centrifuge and wait for it to stop. Open up your centrifuge and then remove your samples. And you'll see a small amount of liquid down in the bottom. All right, so for this GC experiment, we're going to go a little bit more old school, use this analog reader. So we're going to press this red button here to start it. We're going to press this button a couple times to mark our start point. And then we're going to go ahead and inject into the GC, and then we're going to hit this red button. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to hit this button, click this one a couple of times. We're going to go ahead and inject. And then hit this red button.